Welcome to this video. Today we are going to start our form pass, which means we are going to start on a particular feature, and it's going to be the eye to our right, her left eye, and we're going to really zoom in on that form, and we're going to try to achieve a high level of finish. That way we can set the standard high for our form quality, for our value relationships, and extrapolate out from there and paint the next forms based on that standard. Now, the paint is oil paint. There's oil mixed in. So there's already medium there. I'm not adding any additional medium. I'm not using any kind of artist medium. I'm not adding refined linseed oil in just yet. I might do that later on. So it's the paint at the consistency. It comes from the tube. And that's because I want a relatively opaque layer here of paint. I want it to feel like I'm sculpting. I want it to feel tactile and like it has substance in my hands as I begin to model these gradations and trick myself into the illusion of sculpting in three-dimensional space. Okay, so check this out. We have that brow form right there looking three-dimensional. It looks like a curved thing in space. I know for my part, I can attest to the fact that I felt that three-dimensionally. It felt like I was sculpting. It didn't happen right away, but a few minutes into it, I felt like that gradation was representing a three-dimensional thing in space. That's what you're after. And it can take a lot of effort. It can take years before you consistently have that sensation like you're sculpting in space. Because let's face it, it's a flat canvas. That's not real. It's in your head that you're sculpting, but that's where you want to be. And once I get that, I start to introduce complexity. And some of that complexity is what I described before, that specular reflection or the highlight. So let's go ahead and put that in. When you look at her in the reference, you see that that highlight is right here. And I have videos about that. If you look for some of my videos on highlights, specular reflection, you can get the technical explanation on how that works. But for right now, let's talk about the practical application, which is it's a mirror-like reflection of the light source, which means it's going to get whiter and more neutral. And the convenient thing here on my palette is that I have white paint that I can mix right into this color that I have already going for her form, and that'll essentially do it. So let's take a small amount. And I'm not just grabbing it and dabbing it on there. I'm taking it and mixing it into the colors I'm already using so I can sort of ease my way into it. So I take a little bit of white and I start to work that in. And one thing I do is I wipe my brush clean here so that I can then soften that into the paint that I already have. Now, if paint is pulling off and you're not able to control it, that's okay. That just takes time. Keep painting. I was a disaster for years and years and years and years where I would put something down and I would brush back into it and I'd lift off the paint and I'd get really mad and I would stare at the floor and break my brushes and cry. But it gets better. I promise it gets better. I don't even think about it right now. I don't at all. But that took years to get there. Just keep painting. If you have to think about it for now, fine, you'll get there. So I get a softer edge quality there. I'm feeling my way across that form. And then it gets a little crisper here, even though there is a softness that I'm going to incorporate in there. It's harder along this turn, this curve, than it was above. And then it softens a little bit as we go down because the casting form is further away, so you get more of a penumbra or partial cast shadow, which there's more spread between the light that is being blocked by the casting form, and so you get this softer area. And that interplay between soft, hard, soft, isn't arbitrary. I hear very often where edges will be talked about in that way, where it's hard, soft, in this almost accidental way. And it's usually tied to some, it's almost always tied to some kind of physical phenomenon, whether it's the material, whether it's the casting form and the proximity to the light source or the proximity of that casting form to the form it's casting on. All of those things factor into what would be an interplay between hard, soft edges. And maybe you can't always identify what that is, but go into it with that open mind, that analytical mind where I want to understand this. And I guarantee you, if you do that, even if you don't always come up with the exact solution, your investigation, your interest in that will manifest itself in an edge quality, in a mark making that is more sophisticated, that your viewer picks up on. Your viewer looks at it and says, this feels more meaningful. It looks like something that's real and taps into that intangible quality of looking at something that's natural in front of you. And so go into it with that open mind. Don't just revert back to optical rules where you have hard, soft edges. It needs to be tied to something that's true and intellectually or conceptually understood. I'm going to essentially paint a little bit more into that lower eyelid, as you see me do here, and then I'm going to let that dry overnight. And then I'll come back in when that's dry, it'll be dry to the touch, and I'll repaint it more opaquely over top. So this will essentially serve almost as a pretty refined, well-conceived additional underpainting. Now I'm still trying to finish as I go. I'm trying to maintain that same sensibility I described at the beginning where I paint all out. This is as good as I can paint right now in this time frame with the paint behaving as it's behaving. But then I can paint over top of it and it'll feel very opaque tomorrow or the next day when I paint over it again. And then I'll end that next session with another foray into the next form. Let's say the nose painted to the degree that I've painted this. Then the following session, I would more opaquely paint that nose and then explore the next area, probably that other eye. Then in the next session after that, I'll paint that eye more opaquely and go out into the next area, so on and so forth. So each time I try to paint the new form as best I can, it's a little thin. The next time I come back, paint it more opaquely and then explore the next area. So it snowballs and we can really still maintain that same ethic of painting each area as well as you can, trying to finish as you go so that you can keep that standard very, very high. So I'm going to keep going. I'm going to put in that lower eyelid and check in with you at the end. Thanks so much for checking out this video. If you like my content, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Turn on notifications so you know when I post a new video. And if you want to help my channel grow so I can keep making content like this, please tell a friend and we'll grow this into something together. Thanks so much, and I'll see you soon.